How's it going, everyone? It's Marshall. Thank you very much for checking out the video here today. I just wanted to talk about sample packs and what I'm using in my current toolkit, workflow, etc. I have a lot. I've been creating music since 2001 and literally been collecting packs and one-shots for almost the whole time. So I just wanted to talk about this. It might be helpful for some folks that are new. These aren't necessarily the end-all be-all of sound packs or libraries, and specifically, I mean, I'll talk about this a little bit more, but I mean, I don't use pre-made loops ever. So most of the sample packs that I have are one-shot percussion sample packs, and I tend to do my own sequencing of percussion. So there's plenty of other stuff out there, but for my particular workflow and how I do things, these are what I use. If you have any recommendations on any killer packs that people need to get or should take a look at, leave some comments below. Be helpful for everyone. Also, I just want to put it out there. I'm not affiliated with any companies that sell any of these packs or any third parties that produce any of these packs. These are just these are just packs that I have picked up over the years and am either using currently or have used in the past. And I'll talk about why I like some of these. And we'll kind of go from there. So, first thing we're going to talk about is Reason. Reason was the first digital audio workstation that I really worked with. In 2003, I picked up Reason 2.5. I do have a retrospective video looking at Reason 2.5, and I'll put a card up in the corner over there. And you can check that out if you're interested in seeing Reason 2.5 and how it's kind of evolved over the years. So that's where I started. And actually, technically, I started before this with a MIDI tracker program called DreamStation. I'll talk about that in a separate video at some point. I used a sample from Hammerhead. But with Reason, it came with its own factory sound bank. There's the factory sound bank and the orchestral sound bank. Sorry. And these were actually... they left a lot to be desired, in my opinion, especially on the percussion side of things. And in 2003, when I was producing stuff, I was really focused on producing, like, trance. Trance music was pretty popular back then, and it's still one of my favorite genres, but it was pretty big at the time. And so that's what I was trying to emulate in my productions. And being a new producer, I didn't know what the hell I was doing. And one of the things that was cool about Reason is they had... third-party refills. So people would produce these refill packs and you could buy these, or sometimes you can pick them up for free, and they were great. So what I have here is an SSD that is removable. It's external, so I take it with me with my mobile rig, but I also plug it and use it here, so I have a central repository for all my samples. So I have a Reason folder in here, and in this Reason folder there are all my different refills. And again, these have been accumulated over the years. And if we just change this to modify date, you can see some of these go back pretty far. This one is 2001. Now, I don't know how the hell I got that. I must have downloaded it at some point, but one of the first ones that I picked up, and one of the ones that I love, even to this day, is the Drumomania. This really upped the production quality of my tracks back in the day. And again, this was 2003. I don't remember if I got it in 03 or maybe a year later, like 2004-ish time frame. I don't remember. It was pretty quick. But it allowed me to have more modern sounding percussion, particularly kicks and snares. So if we go through some of these, by today's standards, these are... not that great, and even probably back then they weren't that great, but again, for what it gave me, it was very helpful. And I really loved the elf drum in here. The elf drums were just great, super low end, deep freaking kicks, right? There's some effects in here. I don't remember these too much, but I think I used them on occasion. Hi-hats were a big one. This particular refill had a bunch of kind of 909 style hi-hats in here. It's Especially that open hi-hat. That was great, especially for what I was going after. Crackles, all this stuff. This is great stuff. This is still a really good little sound refill pack of one-shots. Lots of stuff in here that was really helpful. The other one that I love and still continue to use to this day, now it's been a little while since I've used it in anything real super recent. I think I used it on the Wave Rider song that came out in the Imaginary Vectors EP. If you want to check that out, that's on my channel. I have little music videos of the different tracks that have actually been released on my record label, Overclocked Music. But this Drumomania, I love because it has literally, I think, into the thousands of one-shots between claps, snares, hi-hats, bass drum, you know, all these different things. You can see here, it looks like these might be broken up a little bit, so I'm not sure exactly how many claps they have, but let's just kind of listen to a few. And you know, you're like wicked when you just are going through these faster than you can actually hear them. In fact, I did that on my last live stream last Sunday. I was going through some sound banks and for a track that I'm working on, but yeah, you can hear kind of right away. So anyway, this was fantastic, and you can see here just the assortment of instruments. Let's just take a look at where's the snares at. Where's my snare? Let's see if this will tell us. Now, this is one of the problems with Reason that I have that really sucks, is this browser is slow as hell. And a lot of times I'll have it freeze. And this is one of the reasons why I was just like, I can't use Reason anymore. Even as a you know, a standalone drum machine in Ableton through Rewire, because this freaking browser would just lock up on me. Especially if you had a lot of samples in a folder on your hard drive, it would just sit there and just freeze. And sometimes you'd have to close, like kill it in Task Manager. And if you had to do that, just hope to God you had your project saved, because man, but yeah, a lot of just solid freaking snares and claps. And Super Drums 8000 stills awesome. If anyone knows of a way to where I can unpack the refill and actually use just the waveforms without having to sample these manually, let me know, please, because I would still love to use these without having to use Reason in Ableton, because that's a pain. But if you're a Reason user, you may have heard of these packs, and hopefully you have good things to say. But let's see if we can see how many, how many snares do we have? It's into the thousands. It's into the 2000s. 2,436 separate snare drum one shots. That's incredible. And I don't remember how much I paid for this. I don't think it was a lot of money, because back in the day when I picked this up, which looks like, you know, probably 2004, 2005 time frame, it wasn't like I was rich. You know, I mean, I'm still not rich, but doing better than I was when I was 24, 25 years old. Anyway, lots of great stuff in here. I highly recommend this, especially if you're a Reason user. So those are kind of the two that I focus on. Now, this DJ samples, this was an early one that I got. I think this was a free sample pack. Those are a great idea as well. If you can find any free packs, scoop them up. Sometimes they've got some good stuff in them. Oh yeah, I remember using these. That's one of the disappointing things though. Sometimes you get them where they've got reverb and stuff and they've been processed a little bit. And I was just like, why would you do that? Then, yeah, it takes away. Give me a nice clean one shot. So that's kind of what I always was after. You can see here, there's some loops and stuff in here. I never use these. Like, I would just make my own percussion effects. There you go. Anyone needs a reverse crash? Reverse snare. Anyway, in some of these, I mean, if you can get a good set of one shots that are clean, you can do your own sound design and create new sounds from those, like a reverse crash or reverse snare. You can easily do that yourself and put your own reverb, etc. The other thing is, here we have this Reason drum kit. This was really cool, I remember, because it had hyper sampling, which with the velocity sensitivity on the, you know, velocity action on the keyboard would give you different amounts of velocity on the instrument, right, on the drum or the snare or whatever. And this, I haven't used this in such a long time, especially with the type of music I do, but it is really cool. And there's probably better stuff out there today. I mean, this was back in 2006, but still really great. Then you've got Reason Strings, the string refill that they had. I'm not sure. I have that. I'm not sure if it's installed. But that was something that I used to use quite a bit. Again, I haven't used it in forever because I've got better stuff. I've got the East West, Quantum Leap. Symphonic Orchestra, and I have the choir and Ministry of Rock, etc. But the Symphonic Orchestra is just miles above what the Reason String Refill was. Although it's good, it's still got some good stuff. Like, I remember the cello being really, really cool sounding in the String Refill. Anyway, so that's pretty much it for Reason. Again, if you're a Reason user, hopefully that's helpful to you. Even if you're not a Reason user, maybe you have Reason. Sometimes if you can get a hold of some of these, you can still use Rewire in Ableton or in another DAW like Pro Tools or whatever, and still get access to these. It's just kind of a pain. Hopefully, it would just be great if I could take these packs and actually get access to the raw waveforms so that I can use them without having to use Reason. But if not, it's not the end of the world. It's just Reason's kind of a pain, especially with the stupid browser. That's my biggest complaint with doing things that way. All right, so I'll close this out. Nope. And let's fire up Ableton. And let's see what I'm rocking in Ableton Live. Now I've upped the scale of the visuals. So this is gonna look probably kind of stupid, but it'll help with text legibility in the video. And again, here we're in my sample folder. I have Reason songs and packs at folder. In the RNS thing, I actually have a bunch of Reason songs in here as well, but obviously they're not gonna show up in here. But this is where I keep all my sample packs that I've purchased. Some are free that I've picked up. Some have been given to me by other people. But yeah, let's take a look. So probably the first ones that I got were from this gentleman named Hydrogen. I'm not sure how you say it. I just say hydrogen. That's what it's supposed to be. Hydrogen. Anyways, I purchased these back from him in 2008, and I don't think he was... I think he was just kind of getting started with these sample pack things. I'm not sure how long he had been doing it or anything, but super high quality sample packs. And this was great, especially at the time, again, because I was looking for more modern style sounds. And it was before I had any kind of drum synthesizers or anything like that I could kind of design my own. And for me, the hardest thing to make, I mean, you can make kick drums like with some of the plugins out now, like kick plugins. There's another one. I want to say it's called... I can't remember what it's called. It's the yellow one. Maybe somebody will leave a comment. But it's a drum synthesizer. It's a plug-in. And you can essentially design your own kicks. You could probably do some snares and claps, like analog style, in that as well. But so from this Hydrogen person, I picked up these four packs of one shots. Huge kick library, the huge snare library, huge hi-hat library, and huge percussion library. These had been my main go-tos until a couple years ago, pretty much, for everything. Until I started purchasing actual drum machines with the TR-09 from Roland and the TR-8. I love these actual drum machines, and I'll talk about that in a little bit, but I still use samples from these. Not really the kicks as much. Is that too quiet? I can't tell. There we go. So, really good stuff in here. And let's see. There's over 1,000 of these just in the kick section. 1,169. All kinds of kick drums in there. It's fantastic. Probably, though, for me, the most important thing in picking up one-shot sample packs are the snares. And this did not let me down. I mean, at the time, you have to remember, I was still using refill packs from Reason, the Drumomania and Super Drums 8000, which are really good. But for some more modern-style claps and snares and stuff, you can hear. Just in the few that I've kind of gone through there. There's plenty, all kinds of stuff. You get lost in this. And again, we're looking at over 1,000 samples of one-shots, snares. Now, I don't know if these packs are available anymore. This person does quite a bit of sample packs on LoopMasters now, and actually have picked up several of his newer ones as well. But these were from way back in 2008. I think I paid $150 for all four of these, which is a freaking steal. I mean, so many options in here. Yep, so these are great. You can never have enough one-shot samples, in my opinion. The percussion one was kind of more... I actually don't really use this. I think I just picked it up just because. There was one that I didn't get, and I don't even... Oh, I want to say it was pre-made. It might have been like stabs or synth lines and stuff like that that's pre-made that I'm just like, I'm not into that. I've got my own synth, so I'll make my own shit. But to compose a beat, I needed one shots, and the more one shots you have, the more variety you have, and you can do whatever you want, which is really cool. Righty then. So, as you can see here, there's several other packs from him. This one I have is more recent, I think 2015-ish, and the main reason for me picking this one up, again, was more... the snares, especially like this impact snare slash prod snare, whatever you want to call it. The reverse snare with reverb. Super cool. And this is stuff, I mean, I could make this, but it's really well done here. So why necessarily reinvent the wheel for something like that? I don't know. To each their own. Some people will say that's cheating. But I say... it is also, but if you don't have the expertise or the ability to do something, sometimes it's nice to buy it from somebody else. Yeah, so that's some good stuff there. Let's see. Let's look at some of the other ones. Stacked claps and snares. So this would be something. Now, I don't tend to use these that much because I will kind of layer my own one shots and make stuff like this. But again, I mean, you can even take a sample like this that's a layered sample and then add more shit on top of it and make a new clap or snare or even... all kinds of stuff. So really high quality stuff from Mr. Hydrogen. Yep, so we've got a pack from him. MP stacked. Oh, that's the one we just looked at. PS. I'm not sure what PS means. Essential one shots main. So again, you just have a huge variety of kicks and snares. But you know, the one thing I'll notice is that in the more modern packs from some of these people, I mean, compared to what, so you got 200 kicks. I mean, that's definitely decent. But if you look at the huge kick library and having it being over 1,000, like, it just dwarfs some of this. Now, granted, some of these may be of more, they may be more usable, I guess, depending on your tastes. So maybe you don't need as many, I guess, could be the argument there. Maybe most of the 1,000 samples in the other one aren't quite as usable for you, but maybe having 200 samples of different shit that fits your styles better than having 1,000, I guess. I don't know. But you could take those 1,000, like I said, you could layer them up and do some other stuff. So it's all kind of relative, I guess. But nothing wrong with that. Again, high quality stuff from Mr. Hydrogen. Let's see. Then it looks like I picked up number 2 of these. Now, I think I got these on LoopMasters. And I'll put links to these if I have them in my order history. Or if I can find where I picked them up. Good stuff. Ah, the Linndrum. So this I definitely picked up on LoopMasters. This is a pretty comprehensive pack of one-shots from the Linndrum drum machine from the 1980s. Now, I'm a big fan of new wave and synth pop type stuff from the 80s, and I use elements of those in a lot of songs. In fact, if you check out the track Imaginary Vectors on my page, that is definitely inspired by some 80s style stuff. You can see here that they even took the time to sample individual one shots and sweep through the different pitches. And this would be the argument of saying, hey, you know, it's better to have the actual machine. And while I agree with that, in this particular case, a vintage drum machine that costs like $4,000 or $5,000 for one, most people aren't going to be able to afford that, of course. So having somebody that took the time to actually go through and do the different pitches so that you could tune your kicks and do all this other stuff or even layer them up, you know, that's really cool. Let's see. Snares. The snare drum to me is key for the Linndrum, and it's what really draws me to this particular drum machine is the snare that it had. So freaking memorable and used in so much stuff back in the day. And one of the cool things is getting to know specific gear. And you know, growing up as a kid in the 80s, I was born in 1980, so by the time the 80s were over, I was, you know, 9 or 10 years old. And to learn what instruments were used to create some of the music that I really enjoyed back then as a kid is awesome. And the Linndrum was used on all kinds of stuff. So this is a great sample pack. This was definitely something I purchased off of LoopMasters, so I'll leave a link for that. Progressive House Future Tech, whatever the fuck that means. I think I got this from somebody at the previous record label I was signed to. And I don't know if I ever even used anything in here. Again, this has a lot of like pre-made loops in here, which is not my forte. But I want to say that there were some one-shot percussion elements in here. Sounds and effects. No. Here we go. No, that's drum loops. Yeah, and see, this is why, like, I don't, like, why do I want to use somebody else's pre-made synth lines? That's not, that no longer to me is, unless you're doing heavy modification to it for whatever reason, kind of not yours. Although some would argue, you know, there's groups like Daft Punk who sample the shit out of everything and are extremely famous. And I love Daft Punk, but, you know, they do borrow a lot from people. There's actually a great documentary on YouTube that I found talking about sampling and the history of sampling and how it was very controversial because technology kind of outpaced the law. And we see that a lot these days with certain things. But it was a big ordeal because people were suing each other for using even little tiny bits of things in tracks. Even if it was heavily modified, you could still get in trouble. Or you would be threatened with a lawsuit. I'm pretty sure most of that stuff's been shaken out these days. But again, since I don't tend to use anyone else's shit, I tend to create everything originally. I've never really ran into any issues. But again, sampling is a whole art of its own in some respect. And people would argue that taking somebody else's work and manipulating it into something else creates it. Turns it into something else, and therefore it's no longer the original. And anyway, so this is Reason drum kits. I'm not sure why that's actually here. That should be. Well, I already have that in the other Reason folder. But anyways, this right here is actually preset patches, and I'll talk about this. I'm gonna do a video on the VSTs and stuff that I have and the plugins that I use. And I'll talk about some of this as well. This is one of the, I think this might be the only preset patch library that I've purchased for anything. And the main reason for this is to learn how certain sounds are made on certain instruments. So for example, in this case, the reason why I purchased this is it had modern style presets that emulated some of the popular tracks at the time, but for Massive. And Massive to me, when I picked this up, was very new, and by getting something like this, yeah, you can use the presets and stuff if you like, but for me it was more about learning the process of how those sounds were created in Massive, which is helpful. That I think that's more helpful than buying a bunch of loops. So presets and patches and stuff that you can purchase for sound design, and then go back, and especially in a VST where you can see on the interface how everything has been manipulated, and go through and kind of look at it and then try and recreate some of it yourself. That's really how, it's a good way to learn in my opinion. This had the added benefit of including the same patches, but for Silenth. I do have Silenth and I love Silenth, but it's a virtual analog. So that's, you know, it's subtractive synthesis. It's something that I know extremely well, so I'm not as, I mean, it's still good to see on that end of things, but I was more interested in Massive specifically. So, anyway, if that means anything. Like I said, I'll be doing a separate video on all that stuff. Here is a TR-808 pack. I think I got this for free somewhere online. I can't remember where I got this, but it's just individual. It's not the most in-depth thing. But it's got everything in here, although, because I've picked up the TR-8, this is no longer necessary. Some would argue that it's easier to sample sounds from your instruments, specifically drum machines. I've even heard people like Moby say that, oh, I just sampled it and then I put it away. And that's fine, that's your prerogative. Me personally, I prefer to actually use the device because you've got more control, direct control over the sound, and you can shape it as you need it. Sometimes hunting through all kinds of samples is a huge pain in the ass. As you can see, some of these packs are rather large. So, I mean, if you started creating your own, I mean, maybe you can organize things in a way that helps, I guess, speed up your workflow. I don't know. I would just rather use the device. That's just my personal preference. But that's neither here nor there. So these Ultimate Drums packs, I've got several of these. I think four of these. I want to say I got these on LoopMasters, but I don't remember, and I don't see them in my previous invoicing. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to locate where I picked these up from. But if I can and do, I will put links to these in the description. So again, these are great. I love taking stuff like, I really like some of the elements of various genres within EDM. Like dubstep, for example, I really love the snares in dubstep. And so I would use, I can't hear any of that. Oh, it's because I shut off monitoring. There we go. I would use dubstep snares in my tracks all the time, even though I'm not making dubstep. Or I would use them for snare crescendos or stuff like that. So, I mean, because as much as I love the 909, it's kind of nice to make shit that doesn't have the 909 snare in it. And these are some pretty good one-shots, in my opinion. And mixing and matching sounds from different genres and creating your own type of sound, I think, is a really good idea as well. But to each their own. So this is main room house. Now this is something that bothers me, actually. You see, these are all reverbed claps. Don't give me dry ones, you know? Put my own fucking reverb on shit. That always kind of bothers me. It's like, okay, so you wasted basically seven samples that I'm never going to use out of 28. So you see, these are smaller packs. So anyways, that seemed to be the issue with these. There's some good stuff, but there's actually way less samples in here, especially compared to the hydrogen stuff. This is progressive hits. Let's see. Oh, look, and there's even loops in here that I'll never fucking use, but let's see if we can listen to one. There you go. I'm sorry. You can make this yourself. Although some people would say, oh, I like that one particular part of the sound and I'm just gonna cut that out and use it. That's fine. That's a whole different thing then. Because then you're using it to ultimately create your own sequence. Whatever the fuck that is. Anyway, yep, good stuff in here. Oh, it's even got stuff for Logic and drum racks. Now, I'm not sure how to use these drum racks. I think you could probably just dump it in and it's got all this stuff in here in Ableton. I've never done that. I don't know how to do that. It's not important. I just take the sounds that I want and I sequence them in the drum rack. Actually, several drum racks. I'll go through some percussion or some production stuff. And actually, on my live streams that I do every Sunday, if you're interested in seeing my real-time production workflow, which is sometimes painfully slow and boring, but you may learn something, you may pick something up, I don't know. If you're interested, those are every Sunday, and I've got that set up with live chat and everything. One guy told me that he was very disappointed I was making trance. And that's okay. But he could let me know. Yeah, that's cool. Anyway, here's some more trance stuff. This is trance claps, but listen. These all have reverb on them. That's not all of them, I don't think, but a good chunk of them. No, actually, these all sound like they have fucking reverb, which means I'll never use these. Is this backwards? Because that sure sounded like it had effects on it. Unless I... I wonder if they mislabeled that. But then again, I've never used these particular claps before. Trance snares. See, at least these are nice and clean. But pretty basic, I mean. Pretty much 909 type stuff in here. But still, definitely very usable. This right here, this is actually not a sample pack of any kind. It's a project file for the vSynth GT. I've had both vSynths. I had the vSynth, the original one. I think I bought it in 2006. And then I sold it at some point and picked up a vSynth GT for a while. And then I got rid of the vSynth GT, which I'm very sad about. I'll be picking up another vSynth soon. It's definitely on my list of synths to pick up here soon. It's one of those things where you sold it and you kind of like, yeah, I always just have this like feeling like, man, I really wish I had that piece of gear. So I'll be picking up another one at some point. And I even have like an old like review I did of one from 2007. That's from my original one. Maybe I'll post that on the channel at some point as a retrospective thing. It's old. I mean, it's like some of the older videos I have on this channel from about 10 years ago are synth demos, but they were originally made for eBay listings, and that was pretty much all I did with this channel for a long time. But they're still decent reviews, I think. And maybe I'll post that. I don't know. I don't know if it's necessary, but let me know, I guess. Anyway, I think this particular project turned the vSynth GT into a D50 or something. I don't recall. Vintage vSynth project, so I'm pretty sure that was it turned it into a D50, and it was kind of underwhelming. And I kind of always thought the VC1 card was underwhelming too, but of course that was before I had a real appreciation for the D50, so I kind of want to get one again and check it out and just see if it really holds up to how I understand things now, especially since I've owned a D50 in the past. I had one not that long ago, and actually I'm picking up a Roland DO5. Actually, that'll be here this week. It'll be here on Wednesday, which is tomorrow or today, because you guys will be watching this on Wednesday. Anyways, let's see. That's it. Oh, this is another Linndrum sound pack one shots, but it was kind of underwhelming. But it was free. And I can't remember. Somebody asked me where I got this, because I think I did a video on it at some point talking about it, showing it off a little bit. If I can find a link for that, I'll bring it back. If it's still available, put it in the description for you if you're interested. So that's pretty much it. That's all my sound packs. So you can see here, I don't do a lot of loops. If loops are your thing, that's cool. I'm probably not going to be the guy to help you out with that unless you want me to make some loops for you and then send them to you. I could do that, I guess. But in terms of pre-made sample packs for that type of thing, I don't know. Go to LoopMasters, do a search on Google. Hopefully that helps. So, and I've also heard a lot of people talking about Vengeance, those Vengeance packs. I don't even know what those are all about. Maybe someone can enlighten me why they're so popular. Are they a bunch of one-shots, or are they pre-made loops? Like, what is it? I suppose I could search myself, but I don't know. Maybe I don't want to do that, okay? Oh boy. Okay, that's it. It's late, guys. I'm going to bed here. Yeah, hopefully this helped you out. If it didn't, I apologize. You know, let me know what I can do to help you, and I'll try. Leave a comment below. Let me know what you think. If you have any loops or packs or anything, one-shot packs that you think are the greatest thing on the earth, let me know. I'll check them out. I'd be interested, and I think a lot of people would be as well. So appreciate the contribution. Don't forget, I do stream live every Sunday night. I'm trying to make those to where they're more reasonable for people in the U.S. I tended to do them really late, and I'm in Denver, and I would do them at like midnight or like 11 o'clock my time. Oop, cha-ching, that's money. I'm just kidding. That's a that's the OfferUp app, I think. I'm trying to get an LSDJ cartridge from some guy on here. Hopefully he'll sell it to me, because actually when going through my grandpa's stuff, who he is not doing well, but I was able to get this from him. It needs a little bit of cleaning. But it's perfect to talk about chiptune and stuff like that. So an LSDJ thing is probably coming along with the MIDI NES. If anyone is familiar with this, it turns your Nintendo into a synthesizer using DinSync MIDI, 5-pin MIDI. Oh, this is so cool. And I made tracks with this. I actually had a video on it a long time ago, but it needs to be redone. Anyways, I hope this is extremely helpful for you, and I will get out of your hair. If you have hair. If you don't have hair, then I guess don't worry about it. So I'll see you guys later. I'll probably have a DO5 video out very soon. Will probably be the next thing. And we'll go from there. Anyways, adios. Bye.